If you're running a business of any type, you really should be communicating with your customers or clients using a professional or business email address, but you might not know how. Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a professional-looking business email address, and it won't take us very long. Now, if you're going to be setting up a professional email address, there are a number of different ways that you can do it, but today what I want to do is to show you one of the least expensive and fastest ways to get it set up. So in order to set up a professional email address, you will need to have a domain name. Now I recommend that you use either your name or you could use your a name that you've branded for your business. For example, I own the domain name RhondaMJordan.com. I'm going to show you how simple it is to actually purchase a domain name and set up the email address. So let me show you how we can do that. So here we are over on Namecheap.com. So the first thing that we're going to be doing is to start with this section that says email address. So we're going to hover over that and then it's going to say business email, and that's exactly what we want. So I'm going to click here and then it's going to present you with some options. Now these various options are going to be based upon the number of email addresses that you might need. Now you might be wondering why you would need more than one professional email address. Well, let me give you an example. I have an email address for me personally that's tied to my domain. I have one that I use exclusively for affiliate programs that I'm associated with. I have another one that I use for my support issues when people need to email me with questions and so forth. I have another one that I use for collaborations. And then finally, I have one that's just kind of for my podcast, which is something that's going to be coming in the future. You can probably get away with a single email address as you are first starting off. So just kind of keep that in mind when you purchase the number of email addresses that you need. I'm going to start off with this one that just says a single email address. So you'll see that it includes one mailbox or one email address and up to 5 gigabytes of email storage, which is quite a lot actually. Now I'm going to go ahead and clip this coupon because who doesn't want to save money? So we're going to go ahead and click on Get Started. And then what it's going to do is to take us to another page. Now, if you currently own a domain, you can set that up and link it here. But I'm going to assume you're purchasing a domain for the very first time. So we're going to click on this one that says make a new domain purchase. And now what I'm going to do is to enter in a domain that I'm going to see whether or not it's available. When you enter it in, you will need to enter either the .com, the .net, or whatever extension you want to have. .com obviously is going to be the most popular, but choose what works best for you. Now, it's going to determine whether or not that domain name is available for you to register. In this instance, you can see that it does say that your domain is available. So I'm going to go ahead and add that to the cart. Now, if you look over to the right, it's going to show you what it's going to cost me in order to get this set up. Now, just keep in mind that your email subscription and your domains have to be paid for annually. So in other words, you don't purchase a domain and you own it forever. Every year, there's going to be an annual renewal. And the same thing is going to be true with your email address. So just kind of keep that in mind. So now you can see that a one-year subscription for the email address is set to $14.88. This is before that coupon I clipped. And then the 1 year registration for my domain is set to $8.98 plus the ICANN fee. You can't get around the ICANN fee. So we're going to go ahead and click on continue. And then what it's going to do is to go ahead and allow me to go to the next page and choose if I want additional mailboxes. I'm going to just stick with that single one. We're going to click on add to cart. And now you're going to be presented with some additional options. So it's automatically going to give you domain privacy, which simply means that, you know, if people were to look up the Who Is record, they wouldn't know that you own that domain. It's going to protect your privacy by not showing any of your personal information. Now, there are some other options that you can select here, but for right now, we're just going to ignore that. Now, one thing that you want to see is that I have applied that coupon code here, and so now what I want to do is confirm my order. So you can see for just about $21 at the time of this recording, I'm able to get a full year of my email subscription. And it's also going to register my domain for a full year. So now on this page, if you don't currently have an account with Namecheap, then you're going to be asked to complete one. So I'm going to go ahead and enter in my information and then I'll meet you on the other side. Okay, so now that you have the information entered in to create your account, there's just a couple of other things that you'll need to put in. So for domain privacy, for example, we're going to associate this domain and enable it at the time of purchase. And you can save those configuration features if, in fact, you're going to be purchasing additional domains. Now, once you have all of that information entered, click on Continue. And then you're going to be prompted to enter in your credit card information. So I'm going to enter this information and then I'll see you at the next step. Okay, so now I have my information entered with my credit card details. And so now you have some additional options you need to select. So renewal settings for your purchase. You can automatically have Namecheap set up to automatically renew your domain name because you don't want it to lapse because that could potentially delete your ownership of your domain name. And of course, your associated email account would be gone as well. So if that makes sense for you, then go ahead and automatically renew it. You can also manually renew it if, in fact, that is a better option for you. So once you have all of this entered in, then the next thing we're going to do is to click on Continue. So after you have all of the information entered, it's going to allow you to purchase the domain name and the email address. So I'm going to click on Pay Now. It will go ahead, process my credit card transaction, and then it's going to move me to the next step. Okay, so now that the purchase has been completed, we're going to come over to where it says Get Started under Setup Email, and then what we'll do is head over to the right side of your screen where it says Account, come down to the drop-down menu, and click on Private Email. Once you click on Private Email, it's going to show you that you have a private email subscription, but we have not yet set up the email address associated with this. So we're going to do that now. The way we'll do that is by clicking on this section here, this button that says Manage. Click on Manage, and then the next thing we're going to do is to create a mailbox now. And you'll see in the center, you'll see this bright yellow box, and it says you haven't created any mailbox yet. So we're going to go ahead and do that now by clicking on Create Mailbox Now. Click there, and then what we're going to do is to give it a name. Now, this is going to be the name that you assign to it. So let's just go with support, and you'll see that the domain itself is already filled in. My domain again was makeacoursenow.com. So all you need to put in is what you want before the at sign. So this could be support, it could be help, it could be your name, it could be affiliates, it could be whatever you need it to be. Then what you want to do is to put in a password. Now, I suggest you put in a pretty strong password for this. I use 1Password, so it's going to suggest a password for me that is somewhere between 16 and 20 characters. Okay, so now I have entered in the name that I want for my email address, and I've also entered in my password. So I'm going to just go ahead and click on Save Changes. You can see now that it has set up the mailbox for the email address that I created. So if I scroll down, you're going to see I've set up support at makeacoursenow.com. And so now all I need to do is click on Done. Now you can see here it has actually given me an alert, but really what it wants me to do is to turn on auto renew. You can choose to do that or not do that. Now in order to use this, you can then go to where it says email up at the top and then log into webmail. So I would click on that and it's going to take me to the location where you would log into your webmail to use the email address that you just set up. So to log in, all I would do is put in the login credentials for the email address that I just created. Now, once I log in, you'll see that it has taken me inside of the mailbox that I could use. So one of the things I would be able to do is to actually compose an email here. And of course, just like any other email account, any email messages that you receive are going to show up here. One thing you might want to do is to come over to the settings tab here, click on settings, and now what you want to do is to actually give a name to your email address. So the reason why I'm suggesting that you edit that is you'll want, if you end up with multiple email accounts, you will want to be able to put them in. The other thing I would recommend you do is where it says your name, I would actually put in, you know, something like support for make a course now. Or you could just put in your name, however you want to do that. So I would definitely do that so that it is in fact something that is going to be recognizable for people that would be receiving emails from you. And then just click on save. Now when I go back to the actual mailbox and I click on compose, you'll see that it has my name and then it has the email address that I set up here. So you would just, as you would do with any other email, you would enter the information in and then you'd be able to send the email. So now that you have your professional email address set up, I definitely want to recommend that you check out this video next, where I walk you through the process of using your professional email address with one of the best marketing platforms out there. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.